I'm very, very pleased to announce today, for the first time, that we are taking the next big step in the AI platform with the announcement around autonomous agents that you can create. In fact, today, you will see us both make announcements around tools that are going to help create these autonomous agents, but more importantly, the agents themselves that we are building for products like Dynamics 365, which ultimately can dock to something like Copilot when it needs a UI for human connection, but also can stand alone. And to show you all of this, I wanted to introduce up on stage my colleague, Jared Spadaro. Jared?
Thank you, Satya. I'm sure many of us are familiar with McKinsey & Company, one of the most successful management consulting firms on the planet. Now, for McKinsey, client experience is literally everything, and they're always working hard to ensure that they're streamlining and improving every touch point with their clients. So imagine our delight when they agreed to partner with us to use Copilot Studio to create an autonomous agent to streamline a portion of that client experience. Let's take a look. It all starts with an incoming email from a prospective client, much like you see on the screen right here. Now, previously, they had had people on the back end essentially receiving these emails, parsing through them, and figuring out what to do next. Who should it be routed to? What expertise did they have in the firm? But this is where the autonomous agent comes in. Now, an email comes in, and the agent springs into action. What you see here is that it will begin to parse out the email, moving through the ambiguity of human language to, for instance, find out what the engagement's about, to check the engagement history, to also map it to their industry standard terms. And then finally, to try and find the right person to take the next step within the firm. With all of this information in hand, the agent then goes about writing an email that takes all of this information and summarizes it for the receiving partner. And what you see on the screen is exactly that. In comes a whole bunch of human-written email. The agent processes it, summarizes it, and sends it to the right partner in the firm to take that very next step. Now, it's worth pausing for just a moment here to reflect on what you're seeing. It happens so fast, you might miss it. But essentially, this agent has been given a loose set of instructions, kind of like you would to a human, and it deals with all of the messiness of human communication, figuring out what the right next touch point is for the customer. Now, this is magic, but it's only half of the magic, because now we're going to go behind the scenes to see how easy it is to actually create an agent just like this. For this, we will move over into Copilot Studio. Here you see that we have programmed up with McKinsey the agent, but not using a sophisticated programming language, instead using natural language, the same way that you would tell a colleague to get ready to do this task. You also see that what makes this agent autonomous is that we can set what's called a trigger. In this case, the trigger is set to watch an email address and to react immediately when an email comes in. But in fact, you can set it to look for events across a whole wide range of systems, sitting there working for you 24/7, waiting for an event to come that gets it going. You also, just like a regular human colleague, add knowledge. Here we see a Word document, a SharePoint site, and a database about engagements. But of course, you can add additional knowledge sources. That includes line of business systems like SAP or ServiceNow, or even databases. And finally, to finish up what you give this agent to do its work, you give it a set of actions. And we saw those in the flow. These are actions that include things like pulling out the relevant information or summarizing what a human has written. All of this together makes the agent powerful because it can deal, again, with all of that ambiguity that a human throws at it. Now, what we saw was one email coming in about one new client engagement. But the exciting thing here is that this scales. How does it scale? Well, to see that, we'll go over to the activity pane where we can look at the long list of engagements that it's working on. Zooming in up top, for instance, we can see that it's worked on over 1,300 engagements, and there are 33 in progress. If we want more details, we can go into the analytics tab. What this means is that this agent is always working on behalf of the firm, and that's very exciting for us. Now, from here, we also see that although the agent's amazing, it does sometimes need some human help. So we're going to jump into a case, the second from the top here, where we will see that it gets a little bit stuck. As you look, it's gone through those steps that we saw previously, but it's stuck here at that one where it's looking for the partner. And if we zoom in, we can see why. Here, for instance, we see that it's picked the right partner, but that partner has now left the firm. It has an instruction that says if that's true, it needs to escalate to a human manager to give it someone else to go to. Now, to see what that looks like, we're going to switch over to Copilot and see that interface with that human manager. Here at the bottom right, you will see that a notification pops up in Copilot. Then the manager gets all the information he or she needs and can provide the right person to route the email to. Back at the ranch, going back to our agent, we can see that it takes that information and fills out what it needs to do. Now, we're excited about this because of the business value it can drive. McKinsey in its trials has shown that it can reduce lead time by 90%, reducing administrative overhead by 30%. And as you look at this list, what we envision is an orchestration layer, just a bunch of agents that can be out there helping individuals, teams, and entire functions to streamline and automate their processes, no matter what industry they're in. And they're so easy to make, anyone can do it. You design and set these Copilots out to work in Copilot Studio. You interact with them in Copilot.